Welcome to a couple of bunkies.
A representative from Monport Laser ended up reaching out to us. They ended up sending us a brand new 40-watt CO2 laser engraver. Our last laser engraver was a diode laser. It could really do the job, but it took up to 10 passes to go through certain material at 80 to 100% power. We may still use the other laser engraver in some videos due to it being not housed and having a larger cutting and engraving area. This laser engraver was almost ready to cut right out of the box. And me being the curious person that I am, I had to go ahead and open every panel. This laser engraver requires water cooling. This little pump that I take out goes into a bucket of distilled water, then attaches to the inlet hose of the laser engraver. The duct attaches in the back with a hose clamp. The slightly larger USB had the software in it. It also included videos on the laser engraver. The first initial cuts that I made were using Laser Drw. Later on, we started using K40 Whisper, and it seemed to be a much better program. Our first initial cuts were just a couple rudimentary shapes. I wanted to see how many passes it would take to go through 5mm ply. At this time, I didn't understand that I had to change the feed rate in order to make it cut through the material the way I wanted it. And honestly, I still don't know how I would do it in that program. Now we're gonna go ahead and try this other program. Okay, so first you go ahead and download the install program for K40 Whisper. Once you're done installing it, the program looks like this. I don't know what assortment of images can be read by this program, but we are using SVG, file format made in Inkscape. I downloaded a sample file from scorchworks.com. Just this image that they have can teach you a lot. This and many other programs use red, blue, and black, and a gray scale. When you set up your SVG file, you want to go ahead and be aware of these different colors because they will do different things. The red is basically the cutout. It's the vector cut. This slows the gantry of the laser to a certain amount of millimeters per second in order for it to do a through cut on that piece of material. The blue is the vector engrave. It slows it down to a certain amount, and it kind of does a follow the path action, similar to the vector cut, only not cutting through the material. The black and grayscale are done with raster engrave setting. In this setting, the laser will move back and forth over the project, similar to the way a printer would work. On K40, there is no print all function. You have to hit the tab for raster engrave, vector engrave, and vector cut, so the program will run those functions. Let's go ahead and hit raster engrave and see what happens. Remember, this will be doing the black and the grayscale. Now we go ahead and do the vector engrave. This will do all of the blue items. That would be the inner border and the outer blue. Now we go ahead and do the red items with the vector cut. Now this will cut through the material. I end up running it twice. I was honestly not expecting it to cut out this well. When I went down and grabbed the piece of material and the RED was still laying in the bottom of the bed, I was extraordinarily excited. I'm thinking of all of the neat things that I can get this laser to do.
Okay, pretty freaking badass. I love it. Okay.
Monport Laser is offering our viewers 6% off their purchase. Just put in discount code Timothy6 at the checkout. And remember to like and subscribe and hit the bell icon for future notifications on our videos.